Michelle Gerlay, specialize in prenatal, postpartum, and pediatric chiropractic care, along with prenatal and postpartum fitness and rehab. We're gonna review the pelvic hug. So to get the full clarification on this, you might wanna check out my pelvic floor muscle activation video on YouTube or my transverse abdominis muscle activation as well, just to get more clarification on what we're activating. This movement is to be used for somebody who has pain from going from sitting to standing, or somebody who has pain rolling over in bed at night, getting in and out of the car. It's a way to stabilize the pelvis. So during pregnancy and even postpartum, our pelvis can become really unstable due to the hormone relaxin. So to help with that stability, we're basically using our own muscles to, I call, hug our pelvis. So our pelvis is all loosey-goosey and we're using those muscles to stabilize. So it's not uncommon for people to get pain from going from sitting to standing. So what the pelvic hug is I want you to think about activating your transverse. So think about a wire connecting the two front hip bones here, the ASISs. So you're gonna activate the transverse. Pelvic floor, you're gonna think about activating vaginal canal, activating anus and pulling up to a center point. And then you're gonna activate your glutes. So all together, you'll activate transverse, pelvic floor, and glutes, and then rise. Same thing in bed at night. Let's say you're laying on your side and you have pain shifting from side to side. You would then activate transverse, pelvic floor, glutes, and then rotate in bed. So I call this the pelvic hug. You do need to activate everything around the pelvis, so the abdominal wall, the pelvic floor, the glutes, just to be protective and provide stability, and then do that movement transition. It can take time to get into the habit of this, but once you do, it typically will reduce your pain quite a bit when you do those transitions and movements.